What's up guys, this is Cass from Viral Growth, and in this video I'm going to go over three different business models and when you should go into each of those. So number one for me is service businesses. It is the best way to get started and build cash flow for you as soon as you get into the door. It's fast to get up, it's fast to cash flow, and it's one of the best ones to scale up to 100k per month fairly easily. When I say easily, it doesn't mean it's easy, but it's easy compared to the other ones I'm going to talk about. So with service-based businesses, all you're looking to do is have lead generation, sales, and then service delivery. That's all there is to it. You have to get into marketing after a certain period of time, but that's somewhere down the line after 50K per month. When it comes to service businesses, the pros for service businesses is that it is extremely easy to get into. It is something that you can actually work on and see results immediately because it's very direct response. You send a cold email, you get a cold call, you get on a sales call, you close them, and then you start service delivering. Pros of service business is those, but cons is that it isn't super scalable after a certain point. After 100K, after 150K per month, what typically happens is that you're essentially coming to a point where you'll see that there's inefficiencies that are building up. It's really about exchanging time with money. What that causes you to do is the scalability is really hampered. It's not very easy to exchange time for money. It's not very scalable to exchange other people's time for money because you have to manage more and more people, and that becomes extremely inefficient. A lot of the times what happens is people who build up agency businesses, they pivot towards a coaching business, which is more of a done with you, and that's my number two business model. So for number two, the model is essentially you coach people on what you know. Let's say for example, for us, we are a content marketing agency. We produce hundreds of videos every single week, and we offer that as a service to our top-notch clients. They come to us, they pay us, and we do everything end-to-end for them. Another arm of our business is actually coaching people. So people that cannot afford our done-for-you services, where we produce everything for them, they come to us and they pay us for our coaching on how to produce the content themselves. This is actually really good because, you know, they get all the knowledge and experience we have, and they expedite their growth process and they grow significantly faster. And at the same time for us, we can take on more clients and we can scale our business significantly faster. Coaching model is really good for scaling up, but the con with coaching problem is most people don't ever make it to here because they're not good enough. The problem with the coaching model is unless you have built the service business model for, you know, hundreds of thousands a month, you really haven't proved yourself that much. You haven't racked up enough testimonials. People in the industry don't know you. Like for example, Viral Growth, everyone in the TikTok marketing space knows about us. They want to work with us. When I get on the sales calls, they basically want to close themselves. And the reason for that is because we've delivered results and people want to pay for our coaching. They want to pay for our knowledge. They want to pay for our experiences. And number three is actually the software business model, also known as software as a service. You might have heard SaaS. It's a very popular business model. It's one of my favorite. I've built a multi-six-figure SaaS company myself. It's called socialstudio.ai. And what I learned throughout that process is there are pros and cons of building a software company. The pros of building a software company is that you can actually make it into an asset. It becomes something that is sellable. What that means is that you're building equity. So if you are making, let's say, for example, for your software company, you're making $10,000 a month, you can have a multiplier of 3 to 5 of the annual income that you're making off that software as a service project. So that's one of the best things, is that the multiple that comes along with a software company. Now, software companies are also great because it's harder to copy. People can't just come in and steal your code. People just can't come in and replicate the exact same thing you have if you have a good software company. Now, the con of a software company is that it's, one, super expensive. I've spent more than $250,000 on my development of my software company, and it was one of the most difficult things to sustain, but luckily we got through it. And I recommend anyone getting into the software business is that they have a really high amount of savings to make sure they can bankroll the software company. Number two con of the software company is that it takes a long time to build. Software companies typically take a significantly longer time to build. The time to iterate is more. The code that you're actually writing needs a lot of testing. Your developers are working for you, so there's a lot of people involved, a lot of testing, a lot of quality assurance. There's a lower acceptance for any errors that you have in a software. When people pay for software, they want 110%, whereas with the coaching business or the agency business, there's leeway for margins of error. So I personally think the typical journey should go from building a service-based business, which is the number one I described, then moving into coaching, getting a lot of cash flow, and funding with that cash flow a software business. If you are a coach or a consultant or a course seller or in the agency space and are looking to leverage the TikTok gold rush of organic content or paid traffic, you might might be interested in our TikTok mentorship program. We've helped countless seven-figure, eight-figure coaches, consultants, agency owners grow their TikTok following, monetize it, as well as scale it up with paid advertising. And we go through the entire process with you, whether it be scripting our videos to organic, to hashtags, to trends, or it'll be paid traffic, coming up with creatives, and then actually scaling your ad campaigns. So if you're interested in really taking your TikTok growth seriously and want to work with one-on-one with me and my team, click the link in the description to register for the mentorship program, and we'll have a call and see if you're a good fit or not.